Siri's looking at me like I'm a weirdo. What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. We don't talk anymore. Last video, we talked about how to start getting into the acting industry. So today we are going to talk about how to get into the modeling industry. So first things first, I don't know if people still use this website anymore. It's just how I got started, and I feel like everything's moved over to Instagram now. But I got started on a website called Model Mayhem. And basically you just upload photos of yourself and you put your sizes and your measurements and what kind of photography or modeling you want to do, whether it's runway, lingerie, swimwear, fitness, all of that good stuff. Website's totally free to use, and it's basically just a place for photographers, makeup artists, hairstylists, even designers to just get together and kind of message each other and collaborate. So obviously you need photos to put up on the website because people need to know what you look like. If you've never modeled before, you've never done a photo shoot before, that's okay. Like I said last video, just grab a friend that has a good quality camera and just go take some nice photos of yourself. It doesn't have to be super professional. Any photo that you would put on your Facebook or Instagram that's like not you out partying and turning up, but you know, like a nice photo of you that shows you and your personality, you can use that on your Model Mayhem page just to get started. It's a good idea to take a portrait photo, a three-quarter photo, and then a full body shot, just so photographers see exactly what you look like from different angles. And really don't lay on the makeup too heavy. It's nice to have a natural makeup look or even a no makeup look, just so people can see what you actually look like. We wanna see your pretty face. So that's how I got started. I just put some photos up on Model Mayhem, and I really only started when I moved to Toronto and I was in university, and I just had different photographers reach out to me just to do different photo shoots. And slowly, once I like started doing shoots and getting the photos back, I just started posting them on my Instagram, and I just started using hashtags that were specific to the modeling industry. Gotten countless of photographers message me on Instagram because they were like, hey, I saw you on the Toronto Model hashtag page. Cool. Now, to start, you will most likely be doing time for print. Basically, you're both volunteering your time in order to get good photos. When you're freelance modeling, a lot of the time, you and the photographer are gonna collaborate together, especially when you're just starting out, just to get some good photos and just create some good content and just do photo shoots and themes that you want to do, things you want to add to your portfolio. Slowly, as you start building your portfolio, getting more experience and building your confidence as a model, you could start charging people with your rates. Now, it's totally up to you what you want your rate to be. At the end of the day, it's your time, it's your experience, it's your skill that you're bringing to the photo shoot. So charge people what you think you deserve to be paid. Take into account whether it's gonna take you a long time to get to and from the shoot, whether you have to do your own hair and makeup, whether you have to provide your own wardrobe. Take into account all of that stuff, because you should be upping the price if you gotta do
that stuff yourself.
It's really hard in the freelance world, especially when you're starting out, to really realize your worth. I had the hardest time with that. People would ask me what my rate is, and I'd be like, I don't know. Or people would just assume I would do time for print. Now that I have way more confidence and experience, this is my rate. This is my hello. Guys, this is Siri. Hello, baby. This is not my cat. I'm cat sitting for my bestie who's working on set all day. So you get to hang out with Auntie Lo. She's like, please save me. Yeah, now that I'm more confident, I'm like, this is what my rate is. I will only do paid work unless it's with a photographer that I'm like friends with, or you know, it's a new photographer starting out and I really really like their concept and would love to shoot with them, or they have like a really large following on social media and it's like kind of beneficial for me to shoot with them, then I'll do time for print. But you gotta know your worth. So that's how I got started off Model Mayhem, and then as I said, I just started posting my photos on Instagram, and now all of my work basically comes from Instagram. I just have photographers and makeup artists and designers messaging me on there because they see my work on my social media. I use my Instagram basically only for my acting and modeling photos. And that is a game changer, especially in the modeling industry, because you don't necessarily need to sign with an agency. I am a freelance model. I've never been with an agency. I don't ever really plan on being with a modeling agency. I have my whole own personal issues with the modeling industry and agencies. As we all know, the industry has really impossible beauty standards, and it really emphasizes looking a certain type of way or being a certain size or having a certain number on the scale. So I personally never felt like I was model thin enough to go to an agency and actually try to get them to sign me. And that's so messed up. I'm going to do a whole other video on body image in the acting and modeling industry and how that's affected me in ways that I've overcome my body image issues and insecurities. The industry is slowly changing. It is getting better, but it's still messed up, y'all. We place so much importance and emphasis on our weight and the number that we see on the scale. And unfortunately, a lot of people are fat phobic. If you follow me on social media, you see that I'm a big advocate for body positivity because of my own personal experience and struggles with my own body image. Again, I will do a whole other video on that because I think it's really, really important to talk about. So, all that to say, social media has really, really changed the game for freelancers. That being said, because you don't have an agency looking out for you, you can get a lot of sketchy people messaging you, pretending they want to shoot with you, offering you X amount of money. I get asked all the time if I've ever had any bad experiences with photographers or any sketchy situations. Luckily, I have not. To be honest, you can always kind of tell just by how they talk to you. Personally, if any photographer comments on my looks, I don't work with them. If they comment on my photos and if they say like, oh, beautiful shot, beautiful pose, beautiful whatever, that's fine. But if they say things like, you're so sexy or things like that, no, it's a no-go. As soon as they show any sort of sexual interest, I'm like, I am not shooting with you, just for my own safety and comfort, because there are a lot of creeps out there. If you're ever unsure of whether a photographer is legit or not, always, always, always bring a friend with you to a photo shoot. At the very least, share your location with someone, but I highly suggest if it's a new photographer that you've never worked with before and you're getting kind of sketchy vibes, definitely bring a friend with you. Ask if you can bring a friend. If they say no, don't shoot with them. No photographer would have an issue with you bringing your friend for your own safety. They do, they're up to some sketchy shit. Don't let photographers coerce you into doing things you're uncomfortable with. I've had countless photographers ask me via email whether I'm comfortable shooting nudity. And I said no. And then I get to the shoot, we're doing whatever look and concept we're doing. And then they ask again or say like, well, how about this next shot? You just take your top off. Like, no, no. Stay strong and confident in your decision. Only do what you are comfortable with. Really lay out the shoot and the concept before you get there. Especially because personally, I'm the type of person that hates conflict. I can't handle it. So especially in person, I get really nervous and shy and I'm scared to stand up for myself and stand my ground. And it's something that I've really had to learn to do in this industry. But you gotta do it, man, because there are too many people out there that are going to take advantage of you. Very important thing for models to be aware of is there's a Facebook group and it's specifically for models only. And if you're ever unsure about a certain photographer, you can search up their name and look at a list of reviews from other models that have worked with them. And a lot of the time when I've had like a gut feeling that something was off with a photographer and I've looked them up in this Facebook group, a lot of models had really, really horrible, awful, negative experiences with them. Again, you can kind of always tell based on the way they talk to you. A professional is going to talk to you professionally. To be accepted into this Facebook group, you do have to answer certain questions about your modeling career. The owners of the group will look into your credibility. There are no photographers allowed in the group, specifically just models, because it's a safe space for us to talk about bad experiences that we've had with photographers, and we're just trying to warn other models not to work with them. I think this group is only in the Toronto GTA area. So if you're not from around the GTA, do your research, see if there's a Facebook group or something like that out there for the city that you live in, and create your own. Go to different modeling Facebook groups and invite all the models to join your group and be like, I want to create this page so that we're all safe. Another thing you could do is ask photographers for references for models they've worked with before. I like to get their social media pages so I can see it's an actual human being. Any photographer that's like, no, I'm not comfortable with that, they're sketchy, they don't let you bring a friend, and they don't have any models giving them good reviews, sketchy. What else did I want to talk about? Now you get to see some behind the scenes footage of a photo shoot I did with Navtej and Preacher Photography.
So we're just gonna do a little behind the scenes kind of video so y'all see what it's like, what you can expect. Today we have a photo shoot planned. Not only is it with one of my closest friends, Navtej, this cord is so annoying, but the photographer is a photographer I love working with, Preacher Photography. This photo shoot is kind of an all day kind of deal. We're gonna shoot for a few hours in the morning, and then we're gonna break, and Nigel's gonna edit the photos that we took in the morning, and then we're gonna come back when the sun goes down, and we're gonna project the photos that we took in the morning onto our bodies, and we're gonna be wearing white. It's really hard to explain, but you will get behind the scenes footage.
Part one of the photo shoot. I am exhausted. I just know our bodies are gonna be so sore tomorrow. A lot of people don't realize how hard, this sounds so like pretentious. You don't realize how hard it is to pose. No, but really, a lot of people don't realize how hard it is to pose and hold those poses shot after shot, and you're like arching your back and you're sticking your butt out and you're using every freaking muscle that you didn't know you have. And the next day after photo shoots, you are just so freaking sore. So shout out to all y'all models killing it, because I'm dead. It is 5 p.m. I'm exhausted. I'm gonna go do my makeup for round two. Makeup look number two. We're trying to go for darker eyes, darker lips. We're gonna be wearing all white, and then we're gonna be wetting our hair and like slicking it back. And we're gonna have a bunch of different projections on us. Again, very hard to explain, but you will see behind the scenes. For watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe down below, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!